Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you about idiopathic scoliosis imaging. Idiopathic scoliosis is a type of scoliosis of underlying agility without underlying bony or neuromuscular abnormality. Flexible curvature that results when patient bend to contralateral side. Structural curvature. Curvature that does not change when patient bend to contralateral side. Most common sign symptom is symptomatic diagnosis on physical exam with patient leaning forward. Age onset in infant, childhood, or adolescent. More prominent in female. Epidemiology. Idiopathic scoliosis development relationship to BMI unclear. Conflicting study results. Topic from science. Neuromuscular scoliosis. Scoliosis due to tumor. Congenital scoliosis. Scoliosis due to congenital syndrome. Suhrmann disease, degenerative sclerosis. Imaging. Corona plus sagittal plane curve plus rotation can progress to more than 90 degrees. Most common pattern, thoracic dextral sclerosis. Second most common, thoracic dextral sclerosis with lumbar level sclerosis. This is from the radiograph of a patient with adolescent idiopathic scoliosis. Depicts convex right thoracic scoliosis away from normal left thoracic aortic arch and lumbar level scoliosis. Terminal vertebrae are at each end of the scoliosis. Transition vertebrae mark the transition from the thoracic to the lumbar curve. PA radiograph in the same patient saw dextral sclerosis in blue from the neutral portion when the patient bent to the right. Residual curve indicates structural component sclerosis. T2 MR of a patient with infantile idiopathic scoliosis, so a typical convex left thoracic curvature, no vertebral segmentation or formation anomaly was bone CT/CD reformation, so the characteristic finding, smooth thoracic curve convex to the right, mild wedging of the vertebra at the concave size of the curvature, and rotation of the spine, also note crowding of the rib on the concave size of sclerosis. T2 MR performed to evaluate a painful sclerosis, so typical idiopathic morphology, but premature degenerative disease along the concave aspect of the curvature. Treatment option, risk, complication. Observation use for curve less than 20 to 25 degrees. Brushing first treatment option, chosen if severe, more than 40 degrees or rapidly progressing. Crankshaft phenomenon. Posterior fusion prevent growth of posterior element. Anterior growth, progressive scoliosis, lordosis. Change of more than 10 degree diagnostic. Presence of lumbar sacral transitional anatomy may inflame post Oh, berarti belum bahasa kerak, kawicu. Thank you.